we're learning not only about great tea, but we're learning about the way you drink it with the pinky
up. Yeah,
actually, we should have a China cup.
No, Sophie Liana's in the kitchen with
Christina. Hello, it's me. Hello.
Well, of course, we know it's you. Okay. But I was never a big tea drinker, but I think because of you, you've had some influence on me, and this is phenomenal.
It is.
Yeah.
All right,
really
so we're going to learn about the different ways of teas and how it's rather confusing. I love tea when I go home. I watch it at night when I'm all snuggled with my doggies and all. So I love tea.
Yes.
But I also like the teas that are available in leaf form.
Yes.
But I don't know how to drink it so it doesn't, so it has, it steeps enough mm-hmm. and I don't get tea leaves in my mouth.
Uh-huh.
So I need your help.
Christina, let me help you.
All right.
Me enlighten you a little bit.
Okay.
So, all tea, did you know this, Mark and Christina?
Yeah.
That all tea, whether it's green, white, oolong, or black, comes from the same plant.
No, how is that possible?
It comes from the same plant, and the plant is called the Camellia sinensis plant.
Okay.
And what differs the original the different teas is what happens to the little leaf after it's picked.
All right.
Oh.
So this is the same leaf.
It's all the same leaf. So,
right.
So a useful way to think of this is if you think about you take a bite out of an apple, mm-hmm. and immediately it begins to oxidize. It goes brown. All right. Same thing with a tea leaf. So you pick it and it starts to oxidize. Now, what differs all these different teas is how the oxidization process is halted.
All right.
All right. So, if at home you like a green tea, as soon as the leaf is picked in Japan, it's steamed. It's lightly steamed. And this stops it oxidizing and it gives it this beautiful green color. It's very, very full of an antioxidant called polyphenols. Mm. So it's extremely good for your health. Low in caffeine.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Do you like the taste?
I do like. I love green tea.
I have a question. So if it's from the same plant, wouldn't they all have the same flavor?
No.
What are you, Flavor Flav? What is that?
Where's your Flavor. Clock around your
Flavor.
Neck?
Flavor. Mark,
yeah.
Flavor. Mark, Flavor. I have a question for you, Mark.
Yes.
Oh. All right, so wine comes from grapes. Do all wines have the same flavor?
No, but they're different grapes, honey.
Well, these are
I know a thing or two about wine.
Debbie, let's just bring it all back from the family.
Yeah. We're going to talk.
So, right, so we talked about green tea.
Yes.
All right, now, white tea is the same, and also white tea is very, very high for those of you at home and enjoy, want to get these antioxidants, very, very high in these wonderful polyphenols. Then we go on, how do you like that?
It's not as strong or as potent as this. It still has the essence of the green tea,
yes.
but it's a little lighter, and I think it's a little airier.
Yes, it is, isn't
yes.
it?
Yes, yes, it is.
Then we go to an oolong tea. So this is oxidized even further.
And is that what we're drinking? It's sweet.
No, you've got a herbal one. Okay. So this one I love. It's a more
oolong.
Oolong.
I love it.
It has a very robust flavor. It's nice and strong, and it's oxidized more. And then finally, the one that probably at home you're most used to drinking could be the black tea.
Yeah.
This one here is blended with Tahitian vanilla. It's an Earl Grey.
Oh, I love this. This is my favorite.
Isn't it lovely?
And
that's heavily oxidized.
So, what, and this last one real quickly is?
Well, this is actually not, this is a herbal tea. Now, strictly, a herbal tea is not a tea. It's a tisane or an infusion.
It tastes different? Like medicine, but good.
Oh, it's so good. And this one is called Herbal Sunset. It's by Zen Tea Traders. It is so beautiful.
It is lovely. What is the best way to brew these teas to get the maximum potent flavor from them?
Okay, so what's very, very important for you at home when you're brewing the perfect cup of tea, it's very important the water temperature.
Okay.
So, if I could, can I just grab my little
tea? Is that the water temperature during serving or during the brewing process?
It's brewing.
Okay.
So right here, this is my tea kettle from home. And as you can see here, it's got preset temperatures on it for the different teas.
Well, what if you don't have that at home?
Yeah. Very good point. I just brought this in to show you that each tea requires a different temperature. So green tea is a very low temperature.
Mm-hmm.
And then oolong a little bit more, and black is a rolling boil. If you don't have one of these at home, then just for like a green green tea, take your water off the boil for about 5 or 10 minutes. A little bit longer for the, you know, take it off the boil longer for pale teas, full rolling boil for a dark tea. But for actual temperatures, go to the Home and Family website because we've got all the exact temperatures.
And how long should they steep for?
Brilliant question, because that's very important.
Oh, don't tell her that.
The
steeping time is terribly important because green tea is literally, and for you at home, if you're getting loose leaf green tea, it's literally a minute.
All right.
Any longer and the tea becomes bitter. Mm. Then oolong, it'll be 3 or 4 minutes, and then for a nice black tea, you're going to steep it for 4 or 5 minutes.
And Sophie, I know the Brits are very serious about their tea drinking. I lived in London, trust me, they're serious about their tea. You never, ever microwave your water for the tea, correct?
Oh, no, you don't.
Right.
And in fact, no, you don't, because the water is very important. You want very oxygenated water. So rolling boil fresh filtered water in your tea kettle every morning, and if it's filtered, it removes the chlorine, which can also sort of interfere with the taste of the tea.
And herbal teas, is the same, the herbal?
Herbal teas require boiling water to really draw out the health benefits. And these teas here, this beautiful tea chest, and all these teas today were brought to us by Zen Tea Traders, which are very good. Again, you really want to consider the quality of your tea. That's very important.
Lovely. For this can be found on your website, too. Right? On our website,
absolutely.
You can go to Sophie's website, which is sophieuliano.com.
Can I take 10 seconds to ask, because I didn't know, how do you, because I only know about tea in a bag. Do you have to, how do you?
This is a great idea. So loose tea, loose tea is better quality than tea bags.
Okay.
Hands down.
Okay.
And this you'll steep in a little tea steeper, or I might show you a little bit later how to do it, make your own little tea bag.